Well, on behalf of Waco ISD, I would like to welcome everybody for being here this afternoon. My name is Brandon Cope. I am the director of the Greater Waco Academies. My role is to I oversee this campus and also our healthcare academy. So, Mr. Morrath, we're glad to have you today. We've got several guests and key people here with us today, partly because the success of this program was contingent upon the collaborative effort of multiple interests. And so we have several of those interests represented today. Mr. Sykes, Ms. Cordwager, WISD school board members, pivotal in some of the decision making we've gone on. Donna McKethan over here, she's our director of CTE. She is a pivotal piece in the original planning stages of this academy. And Dr. McDurham is our executive director of secondary ed. Mr. White over here is the principal McGregor. We asked him to be here. McGregor is a much smaller district than Waco ISD. Your students get on the bus for about 25 minutes to come over every day.
Yes.
And he's sending 20 plus kids here to this program every day.
So, how many total students are enrolled?
This is the year about 180 at this campus.
And that's 90 in the morning, 90 in the afternoon?
It's a little heavier in the morning. One thing is, you know, football is king in Texas. So, unfortunately, athletics are typically in the afternoon, so our afternoon cohort, which you'll see today, is a little bit lighter than our morning just because of the disproportionality because of athletics and extracurriculars. We are, in essence, a special program of right now 15 different school districts.
Okay.
I exist to serve McGregor High School, Waco High School, I know I'm Dr. Shields, La Vega High School. So we, in essence, we serve one of them. We don't exist in terms of the state. We have no PIMS ID number because right. We're a special program. The kids are all coded back at the home campus, and we purely exist to provide a curriculum and a function just like a dual credit or some
sure.
other special program.
Yeah, great.
Other questions?
I have kind of an interest in how you track like what the numeric outcomes are. So for last year's graduating seniors from all of the composite schools, just looking at the 100 and mm-hmm. say 120.
Last year we graduated about 64.
64. So where are those 64 today? Do you have that data?
We do. We're actually currently updating our data. We do it. We typically track it quarterly, but most of our students, 75% or so, went on to the advanced and got some sort of advanced technical degree. We had several kids, he's not here today, one of our employers it was hired by him. I spoke with him yesterday, and those two students are still employed and have since received promotions and additional salary bumps.
Your outcomes assessment, is it granular enough that you could say this is the average starting wage for last year's cohort? Do you have that amount of information?
About $13 an hour.
About $13
yeah,
an hour?
Yeah, for an average. I've got kids, kind of the range will be from about 11.5 to about 18.5. Very talented kid, one of the ones that they're fighting over.
And do you know how that compares to typical starting wages for kids coming out of high school?
For this area, it's above market. Opportunities. The biggest thing here is opportunities for kids. You know,
right,
it's
of course.
We're giving them choices. I think, you know, and mentioned the advisory board, the collaborative nature is what makes this program successful. The businesses, which several of our business people could not be here today, the school district, Waco ISD is kind of parroting and shepherding this project, and then also the partnering school districts input is really what's made it successful.
By listening to them and them telling us what's important and answering those needs, that's what's made it the most effective program, because they are getting exactly what they want. Someone with fractions, someone who's there, someone who already has their OSHA certification, someone who already has, and that's another thing that's made it work. Instead of school districts have a tendency to say, here's our product, we know it's going to be great. Now we say, how is our product?
Mm-hmm.
And they say what they need changes, and we make those changes immediately.
Mm-hmm. Great.
And that's also meaningful to the kids, because they know they have a greater...
They're actually being prepared for something.
Yeah, that's a big part of it. And that we, you know, our employability skills, our soft skills, curriculums, and seminars, things like that. Our business partners are huge in that process. Mock interviews are actually next week. We'll do a first round. Everybody goes through 3 interviews. And we tell our employers, don't kill our kids. We know they're going to struggle. But it's funny, after last year watching the kids come through it, they wore the same thing, tardies, absences, and the interviewers hold them to a T, and they get their little evaluation sheets. And these kids that, you know, may have never sat before anybody before are getting feedback on how to shake a hand, how to look someone in the eye when you're communicating with them, things that have value for these kids when they get out and enter the workforce. You know, we've got to position these kids and these students in a manner that elevates their resume and their person in the eyes of the potential employer. And that's the business league. I cannot stress their influence and their importance on making that successful, because they've brought that here. This campus is run much more like a business than a traditional high school. I mean, the kids clock in and out. Discipline follows a typical business model. You have we just kind of work it that way. So they're very well acclimated to that framework and that mindset whenever they do decide to enter into the workforce. So.
Great.
You want to take a tour?
Yeah.
All right. He's learning it as he goes. He's actually teaching how to pick the pegs up, moving around. We'll see if he can get it to work.
Thing's a little too far up.
Yeah. Got it. They've just started working, but they've just kind of reached this point in the curriculum the last couple of weeks. When it's all said and done, they can actually get a FANUC certification as a robotic arm operator, which can be recognized.
Has it got a grip on it? It's going to open and close around one of those pegs?
Yeah, it'll open up, and he'll actually be able to take it. He could actually pick up this one peg, control it, make it insert, another one going on a different axis. And so it'll handle all different coordinate axes, and he'll actually control and manipulate it.
This is pretty cool.
Yeah, this is we just acquired this. We got here about Christmas break.
Sorry. What are you building with the robot now? Is this like a movement path or something?
Yes. Timeline animation.
To what?
Timeline animation. So each little step.
So you're going to control and create reusable movements or something like that? Redoable movements.
Would you like me to show the
program? Sure. Yeah.
Show me the circuit you built for the routine.
I'm going to put it back now. It's going to press you. Press my little pretzel sensor if you did, and my front sensor if you didn't.
I didn't like his moves.
I see. Maybe I will try something more to your liking.
Yeah, I was going to say, you're teaching him dance moves.
Yeah, they've taught him to dab, they've taught him to tai chi, they've taught him to... I think Thriller is their next challenge for him. But they build the whole sequence, the whole program to coordinating the movements.
Do the wobble?
Yeah.
Oh. That's cool. You mind if I ask you what you're building?
A speaker.
A speaker, okay. So you're designing the circuitry? Very cool. Do you do that off of a pre-built template and you're just executing on the template, or did you have to actually design the circuitry work too? Yeah. Well, I couldn't do either one of them, I'm just curious.
All these specialty machines here, these machines are actually set up and programmed to run on different gas mixtures that are mimic our industry partners. Our highest employers that we have here, they use a lot of different gas mixtures. So this might be the Central Texas Ironwork machine, this might be the Balin machine. And so this machine is set up on their process. This is our advanced kits. These are fabrication. This is basically layout and design. These are all of our second year kits. They've gone through all their introduction. We've got 12 individual welding stalls over here on the other side. I'll walk around in a minute. But most of their time is spent on the floor doing exactly what you're doing. This project right here, that they start a, the Dr. Pepper Museum is here in Waco, Texas. They asked us to build, you go to the zoo and you have the big boards that you see. That's what we're in the process of building for them. Yeah. We did a lot of stuff like that, where basically they get a concept, they have to print it, they have to then print, draw, design, and then fabricate the product. So, feel free to walk around with these guys, what's going on here.
They're going to cut that I-beam?
He's working on that I-beam perfectly square, and then he's for prototyping it and fitting it into a layout with on some fabrication item. This is Esther. Esther is one of our most talented students.
Esther, great to meet you.
Esther, this is Mike Morrath, the commissioner.
Did you make this?
Yeah.
That's cool.
This is actually a gift that she's made for you.
Oh, really? Yeah. Well, thank you. How long did this take to put together?
About 2-3 hours.
This is only 2 or 3 hours worth of work?
Yeah.
It takes a lot longer to grow a real rose.
Yeah.
Esther's one of our welding sculptorists, welding artists.
This is cool.
So she does a lot of stuff. All of this is recycled material that she uses. And this is kind of her niche product. She's kind of designed this, and she's kind of taking this to a new level. So
for sure.
When she heard you were coming, she wanted to present you with a...
Well, this is very pretty. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Wear it right there on my lapel.
I'm from Waco.
Oh, there it is.
See this rose, Mr. Love, that she made?
I like it. Well, thank you for your work. This is awesome.
Oh, that is amazing.
Yeah.
Once we got set up, the school district committed $1 million to purchase it to build this 12,000 square foot facility. And then we have since filled it with equipment.
It's not gonna cut the whole thing. I messed up a little bit of it, but it'll cut most of it off.
Junior Cobos?
Sorry?
Junior Cobos?
Junior, yeah, Cobos. It's not me, it's another kid, but yeah.
Okay. That's the kid's name?
Yeah.
And he was the state qualifier, so you're building this for him? That's cool.
Yeah, he made him one for himself, and now we're having to make him one for everybody else. So those are some of the kids' stuff you saw.
I kind of started it in the middle.
And that's all right.
We made this project for you, Irving. Designed it. And
wow. That's cool.
He designed that himself, and then we told him we wanted a project, and he spent all morning designing that on the program. He ran.
That's cool, dude.
Ran the program and just finished it out for you.
Thank you for coming.
Can I get a picture of you with this?
Yes, sir.
I'll watch the machine.
Where's Gene? Gene, you got to see this.
Get a little bit away from the window.
Okay.
There we go.
Pretty cool. What are you building?
I'm just making defacing cuts and everything.
Okay, practicing cuts. Gotcha. Very cool. When did you first start on this equipment?
I started from the very beginning of the school year, during August.
Okay.
So I just got into it and I like it.
Very cool. What did that start as? Just a solid piece of tube?
Solid block of brass.
So you machined all the individual holes, you machined the cone?
Yes, sir. First we had to start out by, face cutting it.
Right.
Then going in and cutting out all the inside, and then we actually just came in and drilled them all out.
You're a sculptor.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, you start with a block of marble and you create David.
Oh, yeah. And it comes out really smooth.
Yeah, yeah.
Shiny.
Very cool.
Thank you.
This is the most important part. Don't lose this part.
This is a base to the saber?
Yes, sir. Pommel. Yeah, I don't know why I'm smiling right now.
No, it's cool, man.
Yeah, it's knurling right here.
It's what?
You know what knurling is?
No.
You know what a flashlight, you got the grip.
Yep.
That makes it.
This is what makes the grip?
Yes, sir. It goes through it. You know what? I'll just show you. Make sure everything's hand tight, and you don't want to run anything into that. It'll mess it up. This is worth probably about a Corvette, maybe a little bit more.
Maybe a little more.
Yeah.
Am I in your way?
Clear. Make sure everybody's clear. Don't stick hand there.
All right. If they're willing to come down,
it'll be a bad day.
What I do is I just introduce it slowly, carefully.
This creates the grip.
Yes, sir.
Boy, I'm gonna have to come here after I'm done being a commissioner so I can get myself a job.
Yeah, that sounds like a good deal. Sounds like a good deal. I'm just doing it right quick so I can show y'all. I'll come back eventually and redo some of it.
How did it actually make that?
Did these
rotate while the
yes,
thing
sir.
Was? Okay, I didn't
sir.
Just didn't see
it's
it.
Hard to
it's
get
the
them
bottom
to
when it was rotating.
Yes, sir. It's hard to get them to both rotate. But this is how I did. Does anybody have that screw?
I have it right here.
I'm like, what happened to the screw?
The most important part.
Yeah. It was hardest, smallest, but it comes in here and actually made it off of this part because you can't just make it real small.
Right.
It's kind of impossible. But it just comes in and just twists both these together, kind of like a file.
Yep.
This thing just screws in
right here?
Yes, sir.
Is it already ready to screw?
Yes, sir. It's threaded internally and externally.
Oh, it's good action.
Off. It's a little off.
Boy, it doesn't feel off. Oh, I see what you mean.
Yeah, I see that little gap right there. It's a little off.
Boy, well, that's definitely better than my work.
Mm-hmm. I bet you can do pretty good.
That's pretty solid, man. Very impressive.
Thank you, sir.
Thanks, Tank.
May the force be with you. Their objective is to actually fill all this in with beads.
Yeah, basically, they'll run a couple beads, and he'll come out, and he'll actually pull out his, and he'll test each weld for the height, the depth, the extra slag, and then once that one gets graded, then they'll go on and
do another one
on top of it. Yeah.
And so the purpose of this isn't necessarily to build a structure. The purpose of this is to perfect their beadwork. Yeah. Build their beadwork. Is this what they're using the bead with? Or is this is a bead product? That's a bead product.
That's a bead product. Yeah, they're...
We, in rocketry and chemistry and Mr. Watley's principles of technology, which is physics, mm-hmm. we try to actually support those programs. So we teach our standards, but we also teach to support the Kate stuff that's going on, the science, like the metallurgy mm-hmm. and the welding and stuff. I can actually, you know,
So rocketry is a sort of normal state sanctioned class, the TEA.
It's an engineering design. Use rocketry as our teaching the design. If you look, they actually use a CAD based mm-hmm. kind of system to design it. So a lot of that stuff we teach the design through rocketry, but we do other projects in
that's
there
the
too.
That course is
right.
The engineering design is the
and so concept. it really teaches them the science through, well,
the fun.
They like it. I mean, Oscar, he has something to say. Do you
she's
like it?
She's the best teacher.
That did not sound set up at all.
That was not what I meant. That was very good. But do you like the class?
Yes.
Okay. And
what's the most recent project that you've built?
The one where we went to SpaceX. We launched this rocket.
That one right there?
Yes.
So it's a reusable rocket vehicle?
Yes. So it was a good rocket. And but all we needed to do is we need a different engine. We used the F-16 engine, but it went 130 feet. But we need to go 800, so we need a F-50.
F-16 versus F-15, what does that mean?
F-50.
F-50
yes,
versus
so
F-60?
It has more impulse to go up, to go higher.
And where do you get the engines?
We get them from Miss Orcutt.
And we get them by frantically ordering them and pushing them through. Really
what are
fast.
The? So can you talk me through the parts of the vehicle there?
Oh, we go from the nose cone to the.
Tell him what like we have to push up a payload and all that.
Oh, we have to push put some eggs, and make sure they don't break when they come down. So ours didn't break. The only thing that it didn't happen was it didn't go high enough.
Mm. This seems like a pretty high velocity stork.
Yes.
we actually enter the TARC contest, which is the Team TARC. America Rocketry Challenge, and it's the American Physical Association and the American Aeronautical Association put this on with the American Association of Physics Teachers, of course. And it's a contest, it's a yearly contest, and the people at SpaceX are actually our judges and our mentors. And so we go out there to launch, and then.
How much does the vehicle weigh fully loaded?
It actually weighs 430 grams. The max we can go is 750.
Why is that the max that you can go?
From like the eggs and everything. That's what one of the requirements for the competition.
So is it 400 grams with the eggs or without the eggs?
With the eggs.
Okay.
With the eggs and with the engine and everything. We have to weigh the new engine. So we don't know how much it's not gonna be a lot. So.
Okay, cool. And so you gotta figure out how to push 400 grams, 800 feet.
800 feet. And then I think we have to go.
How much force do you think that requires? Give me an idea.
No, I'm not sure. Right. I'm not sure.
Well, they are going to recalculate when they get the new engines.
Yeah.
We're getting them in. They're on
do
the
you,
way.
Do you have a sense of how much height it's going to reach before you launch it?
We're expecting 800, but we don't. I'm not sure.
Do you run through calculations to try to figure that
out?
Yes,
through Roxon. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I put it in on the computer, and then
This one that got 160 feet, 180 feet?
Yes.
How much did you think it was going to reach?
We were thinking it was going to go between 700 and 800, but that day there was wind.
That's so, not factored into your model.
Yes, and we didn't put it in the computer.
Hmm. And your fins were.
But if it worked, too. But we got smaller fins, so we're expecting.
Cool. Better. Awesome.
Thank you so much for coming to GWAMA. This is a program that not just Waco ISD, but the greater Waco area is very proud of. One reason we're proud of it is because other school districts are a part of this, because we feel like that's a model that you are leading us to, that we combine resources.
Mm-hmm.
Is that did we have a good sense of that?
Absolutely. The kind of efficiencies that you can gain by joining forces make a great deal of sense. So it's great to see Waco ISD sort of leading this consortium of area school systems.
And also, and I think some of this I'm getting from your work in Dallas ISD, is the idea of bringing in the business community, not school districts keeping them at a arm's distance, but making them an integral part of a program like this.
Sure. Well, you know, the business community has a great deal to add to what we do in public education. So both in terms of a focus on performance and outcomes, aligning the skills that we're developing in kids with the needs of the modern economy.
Is there something that you may could suggest to us? I mean, the kids were really excited to see you. Tell us some of the things that you saw that maybe you thought was one of the best things, or maybe something that surprised you.
Well, I was not expecting to see a lightsaber being constructed.
Well, in honor of Star Wars coming out.
May the Fourth be with you. It's just fantastic to see the hands-on application of science and mathematics in these classes. I mean, we need to connect kids in what they're learning in the classroom with real-world experience to make the education that they're getting relevant and high impact, and that's clearly what's happening here.
And I think that's a complaint we get as public schools, you know, how relevant is that? And so we tried to make it very relevant.
Yeah. When am I going to use fractions? Well, today.
Yeah. And the kids were very proud. I just want you to know, they designed all of those things.
Oh, yeah.
And they were very happy to make them, and we just want you to keep them to remember GWAMA and the GWAMA kid.
I will remember the kids at GWAMA for a long time.
Well, and we're going to remember you. Thank you, Commissioner,
Thank you
for
so
being
much.
Here.
Thank you for your
it's
work.
It's been a pleasure having you.
Absolutely.